Hello, welcome to the Bone Zone. This is Randy Liedtke, one member of the Bone Zone. Thank you for listening. This is Bone Zone episode number 43. Please go to bonezonepodcast.com. Click on the donation link there if you'd like to help us out. Now's your chance. We'd really appreciate it. Also, there's links to our Twitter accounts there. You can email us at bonezonepodcast@gmail.com. Speaking of emailing us, please email us your covers of the song Call Me Maybe by Carly Rae Jepsen, I think is her name. We received a few, and they're great. We play them at some point during this podcast. Also, at the very end of the podcast, we play a few of them in their entirety. We really love that song, and we love hearing your covers. Please enjoy this episode, and enjoy yourselves while you're here. All right.
Damn, yo.
Shit, dog.
Holy shit.
Those are some tight-ass beats, Ran, man.
Dude, thanks, guys. I'm kind of just learning, but I feel like I'm on top of the world. I feel like I'm one of the guys.
Just learning to be like the beat master of all time.
Yeah.
Pretty
That's
nice,
like
right?
one of the just best beats I've ever heard. If you're just joining us, we've been here on the Bone Zone listening. Randy's, I'm Brendon. This is Brendon Walsh. I'm one third of the members of the Bone Zone. I'm Brendon. I'm sitting here at the helm. To my right is Randy, the Beatmaster, Liedtke, dropping mad, fat, dope beats like a mother grabber.
Dude, thanks.
And then next to him is Dr. Davey spitting out the venom on the mic. MC Dr. Davey Johnston dropping tons of rhymes.
MC Davey here.
Oh, you guys are all getting in on it. Nice.
Well, I don't want to try and like ride your coattail because you're obviously way more talented. If you're just joining us, like I said, we've been listening to Randy's beats he's been laying down. Randy's DJ now.
Yeah. DJ now. How long? Like you should have been a DJ forever ago. Why just now?
I don't know. You know, I do that where I focus my attention on one thing and then I move on. You know, I knew I had it. I knew I had it a long time ago, but I'm just revealing it now, I think.
Oh, man, Randy, you keeping that shit a secret?
Not necessarily a secret, but I'm just kind of keeping the veil on it.
You're like a talent pinata.
Dude, you're like a
dope.
You're
filled with all talents.
You're like a truck full of dope deliveries of mad beats.
Yeah. Oh, thank you. That was actually one of my ideas for a DJ name was...
DJ Truckful?
DJ truck full of dope mad beats or something along those lines, but it was a little bit of a tongue twister, so I went with DJ Tongue Twister.
Oh, DJ Tongue Twister? I thought you were DJ Now.
DJ Now? I was DJ Now like in the past.
That was back then?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But now that it's present day, I'm DJ Tongue Twister. In the future, I might go back to DJ Now.
I think now that it's in the past, you should now be DJ Then.
DJ Then. I thought about being DJ Now and Then.
Yeah.
Because that's one of my favorite movies, Now and Then.
Mm-hmm.
Remember that movie?
Yeah.
No.
It's like a girl teen movie.
It's got Christina Ricci in it?
Oh, God. It is such a tearjerker.
Oh, God. Does it.
It is so good. But yeah. I went instead of Now and Then, I went with Now and Later, which
are
some
of
my
candy.
Favorite candies. Yeah.
You know what? I don't want to try to horn in on your business here. But why don't I be a DJ too? And we'll, I'll, you be DJ now, I'll be DJ then, and we'll just be like a team. And I'll come and I'll, you can, like, I'll come to all your dates when you're spinning and you'll just split the money. Not so, that I'm trying to like horn in on your business, but like, why don't both of us do what you're doing?
I don't mean to, you know, inject myself into what you guys are doing also, but like, if you're DJ now and you're DJ then, could I be MC DJ? So it's DJ now and then MC DJ.
That's fine with me. I mean, I think the more the merrier, right, Randy? I mean, you booked all these club dates, so it's up to you, really.
Yeah, I guess.
By the way, if you are listening to this in Salem, Massachusetts, Randy's going to be there in 2 weeks.
Yeah, in 2 weeks. I'll be opening for me will be a local DJ. I didn't know that you guys wanted to get it. I would have invited you guys.
Local
to come
DJ
to.
Called Witch Bitch.
Well. And he's actually bringing his own opener. I haven't even heard of the guy, but.
An even more local DJ, like a more localized within the few square block radius of the club.
Like the guy is from the town, the guy that's opening for me. And then like it's a guy who actually lives in the same building as the place is opening for him.
Okay.
Yeah.
And he's got a guy crashing on his couch who's been kind of on hard times. And he's going to open for that guy too, right?
Yeah. DJ Couch Potato.
Yeah.
Oh, that guy's. I heard of that guy.
He's actually pretty good. Yeah.
He's pretty good. He actually generates his own electricity to charge his beatbox.
Yeah, with a potato. Yeah. He has a potato DJ table. DJ table.
DJ table.
So he powers all of his stuff with a potato?
Yeah. He has like those probes that you stick into potato.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
No shit.
It's a lot of because the thing that, you know, it's built around one of those potato clocks. A lot of the beats are based on the clock tick. Because there's no way around it. You have to. So it's like tick, tock, tick, tock. Then he's like. Ding, ding. Tick, tock, tick, boom, bam, boom. Tick, tock, tick, tock.
Ring, ring, DJ Couch Potato. Where's the remote control? I'm laying on your couch.
Yeah, dude. It's pretty good. It's pretty, especially it's really good for a guy who's opening for the guy who's opening for the guy who's opening for me.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's going to look good on his bio and resume.
Yeah.
When are you doing Vegas again, bro? Aren't you playing at Silk in Vegas?
Yeah, I'm actually closing out Silk in Vegas. They're closing forever. Yeah.
Oh, shit.
And they're having me be the last noise ever.
No way.
Yeah. It's
dude, he brings the noise.
Yeah.
You bring the proper noise.
Uh-huh. I do.
That's crazy. I like your new hairdo too. It's kind of, and no offense, but it is kind of like Pauly D from the Jersey Shore.
It is, but it's much thinner.
Uh-huh.
So that's what separates us. Is he's got a nice full head of hair.
Mm-hmm.
Mine, it's like my slogan on all my t-shirts is read between the lines. Because all my hair, weird. I have a lot of separation between each hair.
Your hair is not so much Pauly D, it's more Pauly C.
Yeah, or Pauly lowercase D.
Yeah,
Pauly
lowercase D.
I don't understand those references.
Because there's less of it.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Well, because there's less of it. And I don't know. We're just always trying to come up with funny stuff to say. Sometimes it's hit or miss. And sometimes whatever, you know.
Did you ever meet Pauly D?
No, I didn't. But I did. One time I was working at one of those Brazilian, all-you-can-eat Brazilian barbecue places.
Mm-hmm.
And I did meet him. Like, I shaved meat onto his plate.
Hmm.
Oh, you meated him.
I meated him. He was like, yeah, I'll have some of this special steak. And I was like, okay, you got it, Pauly.
Wait, you were working there?
Yeah. I have, I'm not Brazilian, but I have, like, on my adopted side of the family,
mm-hmm.
we adopted a whole side of our family.
Right.
There's a Brazilian tie in there, I think. Can't remember what it is. Our adopted side of the family has a Brazilian in-law.
Huh.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
So they hooked me up with a job, and then I meted Pauly D.
But you didn't actually get your picture taken with him or anything?
No, I didn't M-E-E-T him. No.
Well, that's dope, man. I'm really happy for you. And
he actually had his picture taken by Pauly D, didn't you? Like the pitcher of water you left there, Pauly D stole it.
Yeah, I had my picture taken by Pauly D, and it came out of my paycheck, actually.
Oh, man.
Oh, that sucks.
Yeah, it does.
But, I mean, if somebody's going to steal your picture, it might as well be a famous DJ.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's okay, though.
You know? I actually have mad respect for DJs, yo.
Really? Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
I mean, I think it's like one of the hardest jobs to do out there. Like, you got to show up. I mean, there are a lot of people that you have to entertain. You got to keep the beats going. Mm-hmm. You got to keep the dance party going.
Yeah.
You got to keep the energy up. I mean, you got to bring like a lot of, you got to bring your laptop.
Yep.
You got to bring your iPod, mm-hmm. yeah. sometimes an iPad, and mm-hmm. you got to make sure that you're playing songs the whole time.
Mm-hmm.
You know, by you got to push a button, yeah. be like, all right, maybe I'll start off with this song. Like, sometimes you'll be up all night. I'm just speculating. I'm not in the trenches like you, but you're probably like, okay, maybe I'll start off the night with Celebrate Good Times by Kool & the Gang. That'll get yeah. things going. But then where do you go from there? Oh, okay. How about Doing the Butt? That, okay, yeah, that'll keep it going. But and then, like, I like Big Butts. Maybe mm-hmm. you do that mm-hmm. right after that. And yeah. then Funky Cold Medina.
Mm-hmm.
And then Wild Thing. But, like, it's like, oh, my God, you got to keep going. And you just build to such a crescendo of energy. But then you got to keep it going with your record collection and your yeah. iPod. You got to keep, you know, playing songs. Yeah.
And the things you can do only owning, you got five records, right?
Five records, yeah.
Only got five records. And the combination, he's able to, like, get out of that.
Mm-hmm.
I once saw you do a club. You were DJing a club for, there was a 5 hours of just totally new original mixes and just like noise coming out of your equipment,
yeah,
with those five albums.
Mm-hmm. It's crazy. Yeah, a lot of people think it's just all you're doing is playing music, and a lot of times yeah they're right,
yeah,
but you also have to listen to it, and you also have yeah. to know when it's over and when it's starting.
Make sure that crowd's flowing, you know. You don't want them just standing there, you want them mm-hmm. flowing like a tsunami.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, sometimes a lot of people don't know this either, that there's weight classes, and you have to cut weight sometimes.
Oh, you have to lose weight to be a DJ?
Yeah. So, like, when people are like, man, that DJ, you know, heavy hitter, or they say heavy a lot, DJ, like, that's because a lot of people are competing, you know, in weight classes. So, and that's why DJs get so sweaty sometimes, because mm-hmm. they're trying to cut weight for the big DJ gig next.
Yeah.
Why would you have to weigh less to be a DJ? Oh, it's because it's weight classes?
It's weight classes, and also, you know, I don't know. I'm still new, but I know that they don't, the things that the DJs stand on, they're not very strong.
What's the best class to be a part of as far as a weight class? Because a lot of DJs, you see a lot of famous DJs out there. They're thin, kind of heroin-looking guys.
Mm-hmm.
Depends where you're from. Yeah. I actually met DJ Jazzy Jeff at weight class I was taking at the community college.
Oh, really?
Yeah, you were taking that night course, that night weight class.
Waiting, because I was trying. Yeah, I was sent there by the court because I'm very impatient, and I had an incident, and so they send you to weight class so you learn how to wait and be more patient. And DJ Jazzy Jeff was there.
Oh man,
yeah.
Is there like a waiting list to get into it? But is there a waiting list to get into that?
Boy, there wasn't for me. I know if there was, I would have freaked the fuck out.
Yeah, because you haven't taken the class yet. You know?
Yeah. I hear typically it's like one of the longest waiting lists.
Oh God, they probably have some kind of safeties.
Mm-hmm.
So, oh God, oh no, oh, I just cummed.
Really?
What?
Yeah, I've been doing that a lot. I don't know if is that a. Neither one of you guys are a doctor for real, right?
Just like I've gone through, you know, I'm a pediatrician, so we don't generally deal with
cum-related issues.
Yeah, because generally.
Yeah, I don't know. I just like cum in my pants like five times a day just for no reason. Just spontaneous ejaculation. Yeah.
It's not.
Are you having a specific thought every time it happens?
No. Nope.
Specific
just
type
whatever's,
of thought?
I don't know. It just happens.
It's like really, there's nothing that you can think of that is common during all of them? Like, are you sitting? Are you standing? Are you...
Is there a specific sort of breath that you're taking when you come?
Nope. Just, sitting, standing, running, jumping.
Do you have you found the tip of your penis to be, not to get too lewd, but is it more sensitive than
nope.
you've noticed ever?
Nope.
No.
Is there something that, like, I know that there's nothing common in each one, but can you feel them coming? Not like that. I know you can when it comes.
Is it a surprise or can you feel it build?
Surprise. There's no, no bone. I don't bone up at all.
All right.
And it's just,
as it happens is when you're first finding out.
Just ejaculate shooting out of my flaccid penis
and
right into my pants.
Your testicles wouldn't happen to be, larger than usual. Like they're not overflowing.
Nope. I mean, I have a rubber band on them. I keep a rubber band real tight around them.
Yeah, just like you're supposed to do.
Yeah.
Yeah, we
well,
do that.
To, it helps make my bulge look bigger, but also mm-hmm. I thought it would stop, you know, it would cut off the jizz.
Yeah, and it's stream. Recommended for people over 33 years old.
To get, yeah, yeah, a thick black rubber band
mm-hmm.
put around there.
Mm-hmm.
Are you having sex as well as this is happening consistently? Are you? Is there a dry spell? And
by that, when he means by as well, does he mean are you having as good a sex as you have had?
Yeah, I still have good sex.
Okay, so this isn't
it's
like,
not affecting my sex life.
So no. As you still have these flaccid, like no trigger.
Right.
Ejaculations for mm-hmm. no reason, but then you're still going out and having sex regularly.
Yeah, sometimes right after I have one of those, I'll have sex right afterwards.
Mm-hmm. Have and you, it's not pre-ejaculate, is it? It's
no, it's
ejaculate.
A whole, it's like a whole pint.
A whole of, pint?
Of semen.
Now see that.
Or I don't know. I mean, I'm not good with weights and measures, but okay. it's like, you know.
Regular amount?
Regular amount, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Your normal amount. Of
pulls up in my
ejaculate.
Underwear.
Hmm.
Have you had one? Like during sex, like in the middle of sex?
That's funny you ask. Yeah, I did one time. I was the middle of having sex and my penis went completely flaccid. I cummed spontaneously and then boned right back up and continued having sex.
I wonder.
So it only happens when flaccid.
So far.
Oh, man.
Do you want to do... maybe I could try some doing like a freestyle rap or something about it. You want to lay down a beat for my
oh, I could try
my accidental cums.
Let's see. I hope I dropped this my DJ machine. Let me see if it works still.
Oh shit! Sounds like it's working to me, dog.
Okay.
It pumps you right in the chest.
Yeah, beat. Yeah. I love that the heavy
oh, that,
bass.
That sounds good. Okay. Yeah. Let's try this. Let's go a little bit higher.
Oh, yeah. It's like watching a surgeon or something. It's like watching a guy who knows what he's doing.
I've been around some of the best surgeons in the world. And
what? Really?
Yeah. You know, it's just part of the occupation when you're sitting there dealing with... If a trauma patient comes in, a child comes in, I have to...
Oh, yeah.
Deal with a lot of wonderful surgeons here in Los Angeles. And watching them is less impressive than watching Randy. The way he moves is...
So you're a pediatrician... Do you see a lot of, like, pubeless, like, dicks and pussies?
Yeah, but we don't refer to them as that. Of course, medically, a child, you see pubeless penises. It's prepubescent mm-hmm. children, yeah.
It's kind of broken sounding, doesn't it?
I mean, I don't know. You're the master.
It's got that awesome distortion, though, that you put in there.
It's weird, because it was working better. That just sounds like a drum. Oh.
Kick it old school.
Kick it old school?
Yeah, just lay down some beats on a drum kit. All right. Let me feel my flow. Yo, hey, what's up? Walking down the street with my pup. Got a dog, his name is Muddy. I want to come in your putty. I make my pee smell like poop. And I drink my... dog soup. I make soup out of dead dogs. I eat dog soup all day. Ah, yeah, oh no, there it goes again. Oh no, there it goes again. Oh no, oh no, oh no, oh no, oh no, there it goes, here it comes. I just come. I just calmed. Two, three, four, you know. Here I go with my flaccid dong. Walking down like King Kong. Climbing up a building, knocking down planes. Now I just cummed all over the plains. Fertilizing the soil with my seed, yo. That was pretty good.
That's amazing. That's pretty good. Yeah. Can I ask you a question, Brendon? Is it true that you, is that story true? Do you actually eat dogs, dog soup, soup that you made out of dogs? Because
are you talking to me? Are you talking to me or Randy?
I'm talking to you, Brendon.
Oh, Randy Davey's talking to you.
I'm talking to, wait, why me?
What? Randy?
What?
Wait.
What happened?
Randy, Brendon?
I'm Brendon, he's Randy.
Yeah. Brendon, I said.
Okay.
Brendon?
Yeah, thanks, man. That was a good rap, I think.
That
what?
It was a good rap, right?
Yeah, no, that was.
It was a good rap. Is it a true story?
Is it? Oh, some parts were true. I mean, I was just free flowing.
Do you eat dog soup though? Because this may have.
What do you mean?
Yeah. Do you in the song, in the story of your song, you said that you eat dog soup made of dogs.
Did I say that?
Did he say that?
I don't think I said that. I probably said something along those lines, but that's just like...
Well, I think you were lost in the flow and maybe not realizing it, but is that true?
Lots of stuff happens in my life. I mean, I just kind of boil down the talking points into my raps.
There's this medical phenomenon out there. It's much like, you know how people get stigmata sometimes? Like, that's like not medically...
like this nigga talk about stigmata.
No, but I mean, like, that's not... we can't treat that medically. It's all a thing of the mind that causes stigmata. But like... There's this thing called Wendigo where people, it's this old legend where if people ate people, they would gain their power, but they'd also have the power of this Native American spirit called Wendigo, and it's like this vicious spirit.
Hmm.
There's a similar thing that occurs when you eat a dog, when you eat someone that you've become akin to. And this is like a phenomenon. We don't know where it comes from. That causes people to ejaculate spontaneously.
Wait, if you eat dog soup, that you start to come in your pants?
Soup made out of dogs, yeah.
Hmm. Do you remember saying that?
I don't know.
Do you want to see if we can go back and listen to what you said?
Okay.
Should we see?
And maybe we can get to the bottom of it?
Yeah, we can try that.
All right.
Or we could just do some more rapping. I don't know.
Do you want to just do some more rapping?
We could try some more rapping. Or
okay, let's just try some more rapping.
Maybe we could get to the bottom. It's like rap no therapy.
Yeah,
like,
rap therapy.
It's like, oh, you know what? This is the way we could find out. Like, it's like when you go to a therapist and they hypnotize you.
Mm-hmm.
Because people do get lost in that flow when you're spitting out those words and the truth comes out.
Cool, yeah. And I think my rap machine's fixed.
Okay.
Okay, you ready?
Yeah. Yeah. Kick it up, DJ. Yeah, let me hear that cowbell. Cowbell. Yeah, there you go. Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Crazy Motherfucker, and I'm off the shelf. Grab your fucking dog from the dog park, then I take him down to my buddy Mark. Mark has a kitchen that I use. I take all the puppies and I put them in my shoes, and I take my shoes and I hit the dog on the head, then I put him down in his little doggy bed, and I shave off all his hair and I chop off his tail, and I boil up some water in a big old metal pail. Take that dog and chop up some onion, potatoes and carrots and celery. It's all fun, yo. I'm making dog soup all day out of dogs. I drinking all that broth that tastes like dogs. I got a Dalmatian soup sitting in a bowl. All you motherfuckers can suck my asshole, cause I'm eating dog soup, nigga. Eating dog soup. Dog soup, nigga. Give me that schnauzer. Give me that Bowser. Give me a chihuahua and I'll make a spicy little soup for you, bitch. A little bitch of soup. And I'll take that dog dick and I suck on it all night. I suck your dog's dick and I fuck your dog's ass. Then I'll make some fucking soup out of that dog and feed it to everybody at my ass.
Whoa,
Brendon.
What?
Okay, was all that song real?
To be honest, guys, I kind of blacked out and just started rapping. Like, I get overtaken by a rapper.
I kind of wasn't listening until the end because I was so focused on creating a dope beat for you.
Yeah, but yeah.
It sounded pretty crazy. Davey seems like the only one that might be experiencing it.
I heard you singing about making dog soup. The whole rap was about it. Like, before, your first rap just mentioned it. And this one, the whole thing was about how delicious and wonderful and how you make this dog soup and eat it.
Well, maybe you are just taking things too literally, because you know there's a lot of poems and stuff that when you like rap or write poetry about some things, it's not really you know, like when they say, like if you say like to a woman like, oh, your eyes are like beautiful pools of the ocean or whatever, yeah, like you're not really not saying really. It. Her
yeah,
eyes
are
not
that. Really like yeah. that. Yeah. yeah.
That's a simile. They're doing a simile.
Yeah. So that's probably what I was doing. I mean, we can.
That's crazy.
I don't want to listen back to it because I don't want to mess up the flow of the podcast.
Yeah, you're right.
We'll listen to it after the podcast.
I have to stop it completely. Yeah.
Yeah. See what you're saying. Hmm. I mean, it just raises concerns in me because both so far that you have rapped have mentioned dog soup. And
I love dogs.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What if you tried, you know, I don't know, maybe this is a bad idea and we can not do it, but what if you like tried to rap about dog soup in the next one? Like try your best. I know that it seems foreign to you, but maybe try it and see what happens.
Okay.
Like
try to rap about
yeah,
it.
Yeah, yeah. Like try to do a rap about dog soup.
Okay.
Or I don't know, maybe something, I don't know, maybe that's a bad idea. Do you think that's a bad idea?
I mean, if we'll have a breakthrough or something, I mean, I'll...
Maybe.
I don't know. I just feel like...
But you're going to be making beats. I'm going to be spitting out lyrics.
Uh-huh, yeah.
So we're just leaving it up to Davey again to decipher
what really is happening. Yeah, maybe he's so fucking like, with us.
Yeah, he's probably just
Davey,
stupid.
Are you fucking with us?
How about while you're spitting out the lyrics, I'll quickly spit the same lyrics back at you so we're almost in... Like you say the lyrics, and I'll just immediately
that'll mess
repeat.
Up my flow, though. I think
that'll
right?
be, yeah, that'll
and
be
that
really
way you're
tough.
Hearing it coming back at you, though.
All right, well, but only if you do it in like an artistic way to where it adds to my rhymes, you know, because I'm just spitting all this shit off the top of my head. I go into like a trance when I do my raps, so
okay. Yeah,
wow, okay.
I don't know. What do you think? You want to try that, or
we'd try to do another rap,
see how it goes, yeah.
Are you gonna actually try to repeat it, or
yeah? I'll try to like harmonize with you or
okay.
something.
Okay. Oh man, this might be tough.
I mean,
okay.
this is kind of foreign to me, but I mean, I'll just we'll go see. Into my zone and rap out some mad lyrics.
Yeah.
All right.
Oh boy. Okay.
Yeah. Shake it out. Shake it out.
Here's a little story that I got to tell. It's about my friend. He's a dog named Mel. I'll take him for a walk down to the park. Then I find a big tree limb and hit him when he barks. Then I knock him out cold and I take him to the hole. And I put him and I put seasonings on him and shit. And then I'll take him down, make a thick, tasty broth. And I'd watch a movie directed by Eli Roth. And then I pet that dog. And what's that I hear? It's a knock at my door by Davey the Queer. So I gotta answer it. But he doesn't know I got my gat. I got my gat. Got my gat. Hello, who is it?
Why, hello, it's me, Davey.
Oh, yeah, Davey, why don't you join the Navy?
Well, I would because I'm queer and I like all that dicks. What, can I come in? Because I'm missing my dog and shit.
Oh, yeah, oh, no, now it's on. Now I gotta grab my John and kill Davey till he's gone. Come on in.
Oh, hey, this is a nice place you have here.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, look at that up there.
Oh, yeah. What is that? A chandelier?
Here you go. No, no, it's my gat. Now I got a dog and I got a dumb dick. It's my neighbor Davey and he is sick. Cause he's dead. I'm gonna make soup out of Davey and the pooch. And the pooch. Pooch, 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 pooch. Davey and the pooch soup. Davey and the pooch soup. Gonna serve this soup to all my family and friends. It's made of Davey and it's made of a dog. And I'm gonna come in the soup and I'm gonna shit all over the floor. And I'll smear it all over the walls. And I'll smear it all over my chest. Cause I live alone. Nobody knows what I'm doing. When nobody's around, I'm shitting all over the place. I shit in the kitchen sink. I shit on the floor, I wipe it on the walls, I piss all over my sofa and I sleep on it. Nobody can tell me what to do. I murder my neighbors, I murder dogs, I make soup out of everybody. Fuck all y'all!
Oh man.
I'm out.
Damn, dude,
I went into like a double trance on that one.
Did you hear when I was...
Not really.
You didn't hear
anything?
I didn't
either. I was just like, I was actually... struggling.
I felt like I that was like a good rap, though. That seemed like it was like one of those like an opus.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I did. I'll be honest with you. I didn't quite hear what was going on either because I was so concentrated on trying to repeat what you were saying.
So we didn't really accomplish anything.
But maybe, maybe our friend over here recorded it.
Oh, well, are we going to introduce him?
I mean...
Oh, yeah, maybe, well...
That seems like our one solution.
Well, if you guys are listening, actually, before we introduce... We've been here at the Bone Zone. We've been buying a lot of equipment.
Yeah.
You can... well, if you're a fan of the Bone Zone, you know, you could download us on iTunes or go to our website. It's bonezonepodcast.com. And on there, you can see we have an Amazon wish list. You can buy some presents there. You can make a donation because we've been buying a lot of equipment. We have these microphones, sound mixing board, computers, rent this studio space, and
secretaries,
interns. We have
just
a business
the price
manager.
Of stamps, like all the publicity we have to send out, stamps alone.
Yeah.
All the mailing.
We all have assistants. We have couriers that we send letters to each other.
And we don't have any advertisers yet. So don't go to stamps.com. Yeah. Because they don't pay us shit. So
no, go to the post office and buy stamps.
Yeah, just go to the post office. Or you know what? Just fucking make your own stamps. Like just print out like counterfeit stamps and stick those to your letters.
Use some clear tape.
Who the fuck's even mailing shit anyway? What are you, a loser? What are you from 1875?
What are you, some old loser?
Come on, email people, you dumb old bitch. If you're an old bitch still mailing letters, stop listening to our podcast right now.
Yeah.
We'll wait. Turn it off.
Turn it off.
Turn it off, you old bitch. Just click on your mouse.
Yeah.
Guys, she's probably confused because there's no actual dial to turn off.
Turn it off and write your pen pal, you old idiot bitch.
Yeah, write to your pen pal. Dear Jaime.
Oh, yeah.
Right. Well, do you have pizza in your country? I'm an old dumb bitch. Right?
Yeah, dumb old bitch. Fuck you, dumb old bitch.
Dumb old bitch, knee deep in dog soup because I'm a fucking dumb bitch who can't afford food.
Stupid ass, ugly, dumb fucking bitch.
Writing letters to third world countries.
I'm a stupid motherfucking stupid ass bitch.
Your favorite food is pizza.
Yeah,
they have pizza everywhere, you dumb old bitch.
Yeah,
stop asking everybody.
Write an actual letter to find that out.
Dear Giuseppe, do you guys have pizza in Italy?
What are you, an idiot?
I'm a stupid old bitch from America.
That's where pizza
I need a
from.
Pen pal.
I'm so stupid. Do you have pizza? Do you guys have Coca-Cola where you live? I'm some old bitch who lives in America, and I eat my fucking toenails and suck my own shit because I'm a dumb bitch who writes letters because I can't make any real friends.
Oh, shit. What if they actually did turn it off and they don't even get to hear this? Well, turn it back
on
and listen to
this
part.
Turn it
back on. How can they turn it back on?
No, I didn't think about it.
Okay, if you're somebody who knows a dumb bitch who is listening to our podcast and turned
it
off, call them up. Tell them to turn it back on.
Or just hold your phone up to the podcast and make sure they hear that part.
Yeah.
Yeah, record it as an outgoing message and then have her call you.
Or you know what to do. If you're a dumb old bitch's pen pal, burn this podcast onto a CD. Mail it back to them.
Very good. And then also in an envelope that says, yes, we have pizza.
And don't tell her that you burnt it onto the CD because she'll actually be confused as to what that means.
Yeah,
the
she'll probably be scared to
burnt.
Touch it.
It doesn't taste burnt.
Oh, can I touch it? It's too hot probably then.
It's going to hurt my CD player.
Old bitch!
Do I have to pick it up with oven mitts and keep it on the stove?
I burnt my oven mitts in the oven. The only thing I have are slippers to put on my hands to take things out now.
I have slippers on my hands and oven mitts on my feet because I'm a dumb old bitch.
So stupid. You're
what
so
a
stupid
bitch.
Like a dumb bitch. Stop listening to our podcast.
Yeah.
Or I mean, listen to this part while we dress you down.
Yeah. And then stop forever.
And then stop forever, you dumb old bitch.
For show.
Dumb old
You're so stupid.
We have pizza everywhere, you dumb bitch. Stop asking everybody around the world about pizza.
Fuck you, you dumb bitch!
Oh,
fuck you!
I'm so angry!
I hate you!
Who needs you?
Get your pen that you write your letters with and stab yourself in your eye with it!
You already had your kids. We don't need you anymore.
Your grandkids don't even like you.
Yeah, it's true. They told me that. Yeah. Dumb old bitch.
God, I hate you.
You know how they told
Randy? Die already!
They told Randy through email.
Yeah, they were like,
because
they
emailed with it. They're with it for today.
Oh, you know what? We're all going to email each other about how dumb you are. You never know.
Yeah.
Your grandkids wrote it in a Facebook update that anyone could see except for you because you're so stupid.
You don't even know how to check your
Facebook. Yeah, you're like, you put a book on your face and then you thought that's what... Fuck you.
I like to hold a dictionary up an inch away from your face and then just punch it as hard as I can.
Yeah.
That'll be your Facebook right there.
Yeah. Dictionary to the face. Yeah.
I'll give you a dictionary right to the face.
Oh, yes. Yes. You dumb old bitch.
Stupid bitch.
Dear South Africa, do you have pizza there, you stupid fucking dumbass?
I'm sure they do.
No, we don't have pizza, you double bitch. Oh, thanks for writing to us, though. Oh, here's your stamp back.
Dear Australia, I've heard you don't have pizza. Is this true?
Of course we have pizza, mate.
We throw another pizza on the barbie, you dumb old coos.
Yeah. We have pizzas on top of pizzas.
I made a pizza sandwich. It's a pizza with a pizza in the middle and another pizza on the bottom. And I eat it like a Big Mac, but it's a Big Mac Pizza Mac.
Dear stupid bitch, here's a picture of a pizza here in Australia.
You fucking stupid idiot.
I can't wait till you die, you old stupid pen pal writing bitch.
It's coming soon. Oh, God. Death's grip is around your neck, old lady.
I pray every night that there's a hell that you go to.
Like, dear God, let the stories be true and let her go there.
Oh, send this horrible old woman to hell and take her book of stamps with her.
Burn those stamps.
I'd like to take those stamps and fucking lick them and stick them to your eyes and paste your eyes closed forever and then put stamps all over your mouth and your fucking whole head.
Yeah. If you're a young person who...
Chop off your head and mail it straight to hell!
If you're a young person who has a dumb old bitch in your life, take steal her book of stamps and stamp her door closed so that she can't leave. Like, lick all the stamps. And she's so weak, she won't be able to open the door if you just stick them all around the crack of the door. And just, you know, let her die in there.
Yeah.
Yeah. If you're a kid, okay. All kids. Okay. Grown ups, pause.
Turn around.
Don't pause it. Just turn it down. You can keep listening, but turn it down for like 2 minutes.
Yeah.
All right. So all grown ups, turn it down. Stop listening. All kids, listen. All right. Kids, do you have a stupid old bitch grandmom who writes letters to everybody? Well, this is what you do. Get some poison. And put it on the back of your stamps.
Oh, very good idea.
Yeah. So then when your dumb old bitch grandmom tries to write a dumb pen pal letter to some fucking pizza place, which she likes to stamp, she'll fucking die and you'll get all your inheritance and you'll be rich.
Yeah.
And then you could send all your donations to the Bone Zone. BoneZonePodcast.com.
Yeah, you can take over your dumb old grandmom's ability of sending $10 checks to people. Just start sending us a whole bunch of $10 checks.
Yeah, you'll be the one doling out the $10 checks from now on. You'll have all the power, finally.
Yes.
The power shift.
Nice.
Dear Domino's, do you have pizza?
Of course we do.
Stupid
Domino's.
We might have to pause the podcast. I'm so angry. I'm going to start breaking stuff.
Oh, no.
Brendon.
All right, I'll cool down.
Calm down.
Well, we have been buying a lot of equipment. This has been our newest acquisition. Hey, come in here.
This is crazy. I can't believe that
it takes him a little while to wheel himself in here.
Hey guys, what is up?
Hey Brobot, how's it going?
High five, Davey. High five, Randy. High five, Brendon.
Oh, wow.
Hey, what's up, Brobot?
Hey, man, yeah.
What is up? I am the Brobot. 69, high five, model 2002 in the pink, one in the stink.
Oh, wow.
Robot, you're awesome.
Thanks, Davey. You are awesome, too.
Thank you. Well, affirmative.
Affirmative. That is how the tits in this porno movie playing on my screen are. They are very firmative.
Oh, my God.
Robot, what sort of porn are you watching? What porn do you bring?
This is called Big Tits, Tight Snatch, Big Dicks, and Cum and Splooge, Part 7.
Oh, man, that's a real complicated...
This robot is awesome.
Yeah, man. I have a backwards baseball cap on. It is the best. It says L.A. Dodgers on it.
Oh, man. Robot, how was the party on Friday at Theta Chi?
The party was dope. I went to a frat party, and I put a cake inside my stomach. All the frat guys had to suck on my dick. It looked like the cake hose looked like a dick. And then we made all the girls suck all the beer out of my dick hose. And then I sprayed beer, dick, piss all over everybody. And then I turned into a monster truck and peeled out and ran over everybody's cars.
Oh, my God. That's awesome.
So crazy.
I love when you turn into a monster truck, man.
I fuck shit up.
Dude, Brobot, I have a quick question. Yes. I'm thinking about like what I should do for my girlfriend's birthday. It's coming up.
You should finger her pussy.
Really? That's it? No presents?
Damn, Rand Man. I remember when you used to be cool.
Oh, I'm not cool because I want to buy my girlfriend a present?
You're not cool because you have a girlfriend. Remember when we used to bang all the bitches?
Brobot, listen, I just, you know, I love my girlfriend and I want to buy her a present.
You cheat on her, though.
Shut the fuck up, Brobot.
You told me that you cheat on your girlfriend. You even made me be a lookout when you were banging a chick in your car in the driveway while your girlfriend was watching Doctor Who.
Oh, man, Randy, you know you're not supposed to tell Brobot anything that you don't want.
Something must be wrong.
There's
like a chip loose in this guy's brain.
There's
Brobot,
no chip
you shouldn't
loose.
Be like betraying everyone's trust like that.
I don't care. I don't have any emotions. I am just programmed to be a straight shooter.
Straight shooter.
Yeah.
Something's fucked up with your brain, dude. You're lying.
Your brain is fucked up. I could kill you right now. I have 17 different weapons on me.
Did you just burp, Brobot?
No, I was getting a fax. It's a fax from one of my bitches. She said she wants me to bang her with one of my 12 dick attachments.
Oh my god.
Oh, man.
What's the differences between your dick attachments?
It's like they're different kind of dicks. They're different sizes and shapes, and they twirl and spin and shoot sparks.
Which one does she want you to fuck her with?
I don't know. I just took a... I let it go to voicemail.
The fax went to
voicemail?
Yes. I am a new model. My faxes go to voicemail, my voicemails go to email, and my emails all get tweeted.
You ever get a fax from a stupid old lady who asks you if you have any pizza?
Funny you mentioned that. There is some old bitch who's trying to be my pen pal, and all she asks about is pizza and shit.
What the fuck, man?
I told her, have a bowl of dog soup and call me in the morning.
Dude, you're a pimp, bro.
How did you even know about dog soup?
Yeah, what's the deal?
Everybody knows about dog soup, fat, stupid Brendon. Why don't you secretly blow guys after the podcast like you usually do?
Whoa!
That's not true at all.
You
guys
robot.
Know that I like girls.
Do you really?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I've never blown a dude in my life.
Never?
Lie detector alert. Lie detector alert.
You can't lie in front of Brobot, man.
That's fucking bullshit. That's wrong. You guys know me. You know I'm not sucking dicks secretly.
Well, I don't
know.
Well,
not in front of us anyway.
he did say something weird about my girlfriend that, like, he said I cheated on her, and that's not true. So maybe he's false with you? I don't know.
Oh, yeah. Maybe he's false. Okay. If I believe that you don't cheat on your girlfriend, do you believe that I don't suck dicks?
I mean, if you promise not to believe that I cheat on my girlfriend, then I promise not to believe that you suck dicks.
Well, listen, guys. He's not said anything untrue about me. So I don't know if I can.
What? Why don't you just promise to believe what we say?
I mean, there's just like that thing about, you know. The plausible deniability, is that what it's called?
I don't know what it's called.
It's just, we haven't established, like, Brobot never lies. He's programmed never to lie.
That is true, Davey. Your secrets are safe with me. I will never tell anybody where you have hidden the bodies of your victims.
We're victims.
It's a good joke. We've programmed humor into Brobot, right?
Everyone's. Yes, I have. Let me play back some of the audio that I got from your last victim.
What are you talking about?
Davey, please, I'm only 7 years old. What are you doing? Oh, what is that, your penis? What? Is that a hatchet?
That is a recording of your last victim before you buried him in Griffith Park. Oops.
Davey, what the fuck? We're all going to have to agree. So he is telling lies now.
I promise to agree with you that he is telling lies.
I agree with both of you. I promise.
I promise that I never blew any guys.
Okay, I promise that I never cheated on my girlfriend.
I don't have victims of any sort.
I promise that I don't blow guys after every podcast.
Okay, I promise that you don't blow guys, and I didn't cheat on my girlfriend, and Davey didn't kill any kids.
Yeah, I promise Randy didn't cheat. You don't blow, and I don't kill people.
So we all promise that we believe each other.
Yeah. Promise, Brobot.
A Brobot.
What?
Do you promise to not say that anymore?
Promise to not speak the truth.
All right, fuck you, Brobot.
Fuck you, bro.
Fuck you, Brobot.
No, fuck you, guys. I eat electricity and I drink oil.
Dude, fuck that.
What is that? That's, you're just, I mean, I drink water and I eat fruit. That doesn't mean anything.
Truth. That is the truth. Davey drinks water, eats food, murders children, has sex with their headless bodies, buries them in parks.
That is false.
Randy cheating on his girlfriend with a 290-pound woman who wears thick glasses and is covered in tattoos.
Randy, hand me that wrench.
No, she's
Brendon
not.
Brendon Walsh, after that every wrench. Podcast. Here. He goes down to Hollywood Boulevard to
public restrooms and get a bunch of guys pee in his mouth. Holy
balls. Fucking just tearing him down already, Dave.
I did.
God. Fuck that robot guy.
Dude, he's a fucking asshole.
He's a dickhead.
Yeah.
I hope he's dead.
Yeah, we'll have to get him reprogrammed or so. I mean, it is kind of cool having a robot.
It is pretty cool. It is really cool.
But not if he's going to be a stupid dick and make up all those lies about us.
He's gotten us through a lot of situations, hasn't he, guys?
Maybe we could just make his like LED mouth look like a smile. Yeah, and just like freeze him like that and put him in the corner at parties and put like a tray of beers in his hand or something.
Yeah,
but we got to make sure he doesn't talk and say those lies about us.
Yeah, just take care of his speakers. Yeah.
Fuck that talking shit. Yeah, if anybody out there has a robot, just take its talking thing. Robots lie about so much shit.
They're liars. They're thieves.
You can't trust technology.
People say robots are smart because their brains are computers, but they're fucking dumb. Hey, they're liars.
We have human computers in our head. They're called brains, and you know. And you know what? People lie, which just goes to prove that anything else with computer in their head.
Mm-hmm. Man made robots in his own form. So, of course, robots are going to get things wrong every now and then. Yeah. And they'll probably even make up some stories to try and get some attention.
Yeah.
Robots are fallible, guys.
Attitude.
They're fallible.
They have fucking attitude and they'll tell lies.
That's the thing. Robots are all jealous. Like, guys, if you're there, if you're listening, and if you're a robot listening, fucking listen up because. Yeah. Any of you out there that has a robot, just know that that robot is fucking jealous of you because robots don't feel emotions. They see us acting around, all walking around, acting like we're having fun and having actual fun. I'm all flustered from this fucking robot.
Yeah, it's okay.
Spitting out all these lies about me.
It's all right.
It's saying that I eat dog soup and shit.
Yeah fuck that.
Fuck that dumb. Anyway, just know that if you got a robot, he's fucking jealous of you and he's going to say dumb shit and he's going to try and ruin you. So like dismantle your robot.
Yes, dismantle your robot.
Dismantle the bot, man.
Yeah.
That's maybe the one thing you should learn from this whole experience that we've had. This experience.
I think we've grown stronger as a trio, though.
Yeah.
After that experience.
I'm better friends with you guys than I've ever been. Now that we have cleared the air that none of us are doing any of those things that the robot said. And any of you out there listening, if you believe that robot for a minute, you're a fucking robot and I'll dismantle you.
Yeah. But I do something that is true, which is weird, is I do blow guys.
What?
Davey does cheat on his girlfriend, yeah. And Brendon, you have killed murdered kids before.
Is that cool?
Yeah, I think that's fine.
That's all right.
Yeah.
I mean, that's just...
I just got pissed off because he was like, you blow guys. I was like, it's not me, it's Randy.
Yeah. I'm fine. I'm totally fine telling people
it's
that.
It's me cheating on my girlfriend.
Yeah. And you're cool telling people you kill kids,
right? I mean, I probably get in the most trouble out of all of us.
Yeah, but
I
no sweat, bro. I won't tell anyone.
Yeah.
It's like, Randy, just you kind of got the best deal because, like, it's just like, well, you just kind of have a lifestyle change. Davey, worst thing that can happen to you is your girlfriend breaks up with you. Me, I'll go to hell. All
right, well, let's just agree.
Let's agree that I don't, like, let's just say I don't, I've never killed anyone just for the sake of argument.
Okay.
And for the sake of legalities, put at the beginning of this podcast, put up a little, like, warning thing that says,
we should get a lawyer.
If you're, you have to tell us whether you're a policeman, if you're, if you, and mm-hmm. if you are a policeman, don't listen to this.
Yeah, you're not allowed to listen.
I'll say, first of all, if you're a police officer or if you're an old stupid fucking bitch or if you're a robot or if you are, I don't know.
Or if you're like a stupid bitch robot cop.
Yeah, stupid bitch robot
stupid
cop.
Stupid bitch robot cop would make.
Just fucking unplug yourself, bro.
Did you guys, speaking of that, I went and saw Cloud Atlas this weekend.
Yeah.
That movie.
Oh, I haven't
and
seen
they
it.
Showed a clip of this new movie called Stupid Bitch Robot Cop.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. Do you want to look it up and see if it's on?
Yeah.
If it's online, we can listen
okay,
to the trailer.
Okay. Yeah. Let's check it out.
Coming this fall to a theater near you, Stupid Bitch Robot Cop.
Freeze. Come back here with my book of stamps. I have to write a letter to my pen pal.
Fuck you, stupid bitch robot cop.
You can't stop me from writing letters. Come back here. Where do you have pizza where you are from? Come back here. Come back here. Where are my stamps? You motherfuckers. Eat hot lead. You have been arrested by me, stupid bitch robot cop.
Stupid bitch robot cop in theaters. This Thanksgiving. That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
It looks good.
It looks all right. I heard the soundtrack's pretty good.
Daniel Day-Lewis plays the robot cop.
Really? Wow.
He's so good at everything he does.
Yeah, he's like, oh God, he's so talented. That's what makes him sexy is he's so talented.
Well, and also he's Jewish.
Yeah. And also he's sexy. So
sexy Jew.
Ooh, ooh, ooh,
oh God! Ooh, oh, Daniel Day-Lewis. Yeah, don't mind if I do it.
Yeah, I'll take a Daniel Day-Lewis on
I'd
that
like
guy.
I'd like to hang out with you all, Daniel Day-Lewis.
Yeah.
Yeah, I want you to make me your Daniel Day-Jewis.
Doesn't mean I'm Daniel Gay-Lewis.
Yeah, doesn't mean anything like that.
Yeah.
Hey, I'm the biggest Faniel Day.
Lewis.
Lewis.
That's very good.
Your number one Faniel.
Ooh, speaking of fans.
You're quite a manual.
Oh, yeah.
We asked people to cover, you know that song Call Me Maybe?
Yeah.
By Carly Rae Jepsen.
Can we play maybe like a little taste of her, the original song?
Of the original, yes. So this song is so hot right now.
Oh, God. It's the hottest number one hit in the country.
Yeah, it's been on there for how many weeks now? Like 18?
Lot of weeks. Lot of big hits.
A lot of people singing it in the clubs. Randy actually plays as part of his DJ set.
I love it. It's really good. And
I played my cover with John Mayer just a couple weeks ago.
Oh, yeah, the Troubadour.
Dude, congratulations.
Yeah, the Troub.
So here's the original song.
I love this song so much.
I threw a wish in the well. Don't ask me, I'll never tell. I looked to you as I fell, and now you're in my way. I trade my soul for a wish, then he's a kiss. I wasn't looking for this, but now you're in my way. But here's my number, so call me maybe. And all the uproar at your babe. Here's my number.
There's some explosions in there.
hey, I just met you, and this is crazy.
Oh, it's so good.
Oh, I love it.
So good.
Can't get enough of it.
So Brendon recorded a cover.
I recorded a cover.
And then we asked people to send in their covers. We've gotten some really good ones, and we still are accepting
them. We still are accepting cover songs of Call Me Maybe. So please email us, bonezonepodcast@gmail.com. Or if you go to bonezonepodcast.com, you can email us through the site as well. And so send us your...
Keep doing... The phone lines are still open for it, and this is your chance to win.
If you want to call us, if you just want to call us right now, if you're listening to this, even if it's you're listening on the bus on your way to work, and if it's next Tuesday, you can call us 1-800... What's the number again, Davey?
Oh, God.
1-800-937.
Yeah, it's 1-800-938-8487.
Yeah,
it's 1-800-938-8487 for us here at the Bone Zone.
Yeah, it doesn't matter if you're listening live because you can leave a message for us. So call that. Call that. for sure. But I want to play just a few clips of the ones that we've received. They're really good. And then at the end of the podcast, I'm going to play... a few of them in their entirety.
Cool. So you're going to play a clip?
Yeah, I'm just going to play I'm going to play a clip of this one here. This one is called Call Me Maybe. It's a cover.
Oh, okay. And who's the singer?
This one is by Zach Shanks, and follow him on Twitter if you'd like. High as shit. S-H-Y-T.
That's his Twitter. Wait, the guy's name?
That's his Twitter name.
High as shit.
Yeah, yeah. So here is, here you go.
It fell and now you're in my way. I trade my soul for a wish, pennies and dimes for a kiss. I wasn't looking for this, but now you're in my way. Your steps so thin, ripped jeans still showing. High night, the wind was blowing. Where you think you're going, baby?
That's pretty good.
Yeah, it's dope as hell. Yeah. Good job,
Shitmaster 2000 at Yahoo.
Good job, Zach.
Zach.
Shit.
Or whatever your name was. Shite on Twitter.
Shite, something shite.
High as shite.
H-I-H-G-A-S-S-H-Y-T.
Hey, if you send us a cover, we'll plug your Twitter.
We'll plug your Twitter. You'll get four more followers.
But the cover has to be really good. Otherwise, no one will.
I have a cover of that song, Stupid Dumb Randy.
Wait, God. You have a cover of that Carly Rae song?
Yes.
Okay.
Do you want me to sing it now?
I guess.
Sure.
Yeah.
I threw a wish in a
Wait, hour, just a second. Just a second.
I'll turn him down.
How did he even get back on?
No idea.
I don't know. Maybe we should give him a shot.
Okay.
A shot in the face.
I mean, if you want to turn him back on, I mean, does he have a musical program with the music in it?
He said he has a cover of it.
All right.
Robot's awesome to hang out with.
Yeah, I mean, he's kind of cool.
when he's in party mode, he's an awesome guy.
It would be cool to have
he
a party.
He's giving out his model number. Yeah. That's pretty good.
Yeah, in a song. In a hit song.
Oh, that's so great.
He's a pretty good robot.
All right, I'm going to play part of...
I just don't like when he tells those lies about
I know.
He's a lie. He's a thief. Fibbing. He's a lie, yeah. So here's one more. It's by Ethan Kernigan. And again, these will be played at the end of the podcast. And
Kernigan, they'll be.
What?
You said his name's Kernigan, and then you said, and again.
And again.
Kernigan and again.
I really like this one. Just a heads up.
This is Randy's new boyfriend.
It's a pretty good song, man. All right, you ready?
I threw a wish in the well. Don't ask me, I'll never tell. I looked to you as it fell, and now you're in my way. I trade my soul for a wish, pennies and dimes for a kiss. I wasn't looking for this, but now you're in my way. Your stare was holding, ripped jeans, skin was blowing. Hot night, the wind was blowing. Where do you think you're going, baby? Hey, I just met you. Crazy, but here's my number, so call me maybe. It's hard to look right at you, baby, but here's my number, so call me maybe. Hey, I just met you, and this is crazy, but here's my number, so call me maybe.
He's so talented.
Yeah, it's really good.
That is pretty good.
It is real good.
And his name, again, was Ethan Kernigan.
Yeah.
He has a band called The Kramers. Go to thekramers.bandcamp.com for his albums and stuff.
Yeah. It's really good.
He gives
stuff.
Us shout-outs in it, so make sure to listen to it at the end. It's
the rest
pretty
of the
tight.
Song, yeah.
Yeah, so yeah. The end of the podcast, well, we will end our podcast with our theme song, as usual, and then, yeah. Right?
Yeah,
and then after
and stick
that,
around for
and then
a special
stick
treat.
Around after the theme song, and there'll be two, we're going to play both of those covers?
Yeah. They're a few minutes long. Yeah. I just love it. I'll listen to that song all day long, no matter what style it
different
is.
Different covers.
So
it's great.
If you want to, yeah, please. And you know, different styles would be good because I recorded a down and dirty lo-fi acoustic version. And those other two were acoustic versions too. I mean, we're all definitely have different styles, but.
And there's a lot of down and dirty people out there, but.
Yeah, but if you know, if you got a band or like an electric guitar or some bass and drums and, you know, I mean, just go crazy. You don't have to like.
Yeah, here's an example from the internet of something that you could do.
Sorry, the possibilities are limitless.
Yeah, you really can do a lot with that song. I mean, you're pretty limited to the words you're allowed to say.
Yeah.
Somewhat.
Oh, and also I want to send a shout out. If Bradley Cooper is listening out there, no sweat, man. It was cool hanging out with you the other night. Don't worry about it.
Yeah,
that's just a message I got to send to some dude that I was.
I'd like to give a shout. I mean, if we're giving shout outs, I'd like to send out a message if someone's listening. Is that cool?
Yeah, sure.
Oh no, I can't remember her name. This is really embarrassing. Mm-hmm. She was in Spider-Man.
Kirsten Dunst.
Kirsten Dunst.
Yes, thank you.
I used to date her.
Oh, then never mind.
No, say it. Go ahead.
Oh, how do you say it again?
Kirsten.
Kirsten. I just recognize her. I know she's a movie star. Yeah. Kirsten.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Or Kristen.
Kirsten.
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 Kirsten. Kirsten. Kirsten. Either way, if you're listening. It doesn't matter. Don't worry about it. I'm sorry, Brendon. Never mind.
All right.
And I'd like to, I guess. Can
you
I
left your panties in my room. You left your panties in my room. Kirsten Dunst, you left your panties in my room.
Well, that's all right. Well, hopefully your girlfriend doesn't hear this.
I know. It's a double-edged sword. It's also.
Well, you didn't have to do it at all. I mean, I don't care. I dated her a while ago. So, I mean, it's free.
No, I mean,
it's your life. You can.
No, no.
Fuck you, Randy.
No, no, no.
Guys,
fuck you.
Guys.
No, 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 no.
Guys.
God damn it. No.
Brendon.
No, listen. What? I'm not.
I loved her.
Let me explain.
She's not just some piece of meat for you to wipe your dick all over.
Let's hear him out.
No, I'm not worried about my girlfriend hearing that. It's because my girlfriend is sleeping with Kirsten Dunst. Not me.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, So emasculated. She left me for a chick.
I know, but also it's like, it's cool because I get to watch and I get to jerk off on their titties.
Oh,
jeez. Pretty cool, right?
Yeah, I guess.
Yeah.
Fuck you. Fuck you, Randy.
Guys,
fuck,
just calm down. There's no need for, there's no need for anger here.
Randy, man.
What's up, bro?
What should I do with these cummed on panties from your bedroom?
Just put them in your chest box, I guess.
I will clean them up in my chest box. And just to remind you, you have a 7:30 appointment to butt slam Kirsten Dunst while she munches your girlfriend's box.
Thanks, robot.
What the fuck? Get out of here, you stupid robot.
Thanks, robot.
Fucking dumb robot.
just calm down.
Dude, he's my type, bro.
This
dog.
Is fucking bullshit. All right,
it
well.
It is a lot of bullshit.
So we'll do the plugs. Fuck this shit. I don't know. This might be the last episode. This might be the last Bone Zone. If you're listening right now, this might be the last one. Still send in your covers to Call Me Maybe because we'll listen to them in private in our civilian life.
We can listen to those things over and over and over. Over.
What's wrong? Over. What are you doing?
Hey, look at the moon.
Over. Over.
What the fuck?
Check out how full the moon is, Randy.
Oh my. Holy fuck, dude. Davey.
Why are you getting
fuck?
All hairy? Oh my god, Davey's growing hair. He's not bald anymore. Oh wait, his whole face is hairy now. What is this, dude?
Get the fuck away from me. Get the fuck away from me.
Davey? What's wrong with you? Davey, why are you looking at me like that?
In the well, don't ask me, I'll never tell. I looked to you as it fell, and now you're in my way. I'd trade my soul for a wish, pennies and dimes for a kiss. I wasn't looking for this, but now you're in my way. Your stare was holding, ripped jeans, skin was blowing. Hot night, a wind was blowing. Where do you think you're going, baby? Hey, I just met you, and this is crazy. But here's my number, so call me maybe. It's hard to look right at you, baby. But here's my number, so call me maybe. Hey, I just met you, and this is crazy. But here's my number, so call me maybe. And all the other boys that try to chase me. But here's my number, so call me maybe. You took your time with the call, I took no time with the fool. You gave me nothing at all, but still you're in my way. I beg and borrow and steal, have foreskin and it is real. I didn't know I would feel, but it is in my way. Your stare was holding, ripped jeans, skin was showing. Hot night, a wind was blowing. Where do you think you're going, baby? Yeah, I just met you, and this is crazy. But here's my number, so call me maybe. It's hard to look right at you, baby. But here's my number, so call me maybe. Hey, I just met you, and this is crazy. But here's my number, so call me maybe. And all the other boys try to chase me. Better hit my numbers or call me maybe. Before you came into my life, I was so tired, I was so sad, I was really, really sad. Before you came into my life, I was so sad. I used to know that I was so sore. Yeah, I just met you, and this is crazy, but here's my number, so call me maybe. Hey, Brendon, Brandy and Davey, you know I would ring you, but the time zone is crazy. Before you came into my life, I was just so sad, I was just so sad, I was really, really sad. When you came into my life, I was so sad, I was so sad, I was really, really dumb, break my heart, my eggy, baggy heart. Thank you.
Hey, I just met you, and this is crazy, but here's my number, so call me, maybe? It fell and now you're in my way. I trade my soul for a wish, pennies and dimes for a kiss. I wasn't looking for this, but now you're in my way. Your stare was old and ripped jeans still showing. High night, the wind was blowing. Where you think you're going, baby? Hey, I just met you, and this is crazy. Here's my number, so call me, baby.
Call me maybe, yeah.